The story starts on a dimly lit living room with scattered furniture. Peggy Hodgson, a worried mother, sits on a worn-out sofa, her face filled with fear. Sounds of whispers and distant footsteps echo through the house. Peggy enters her children's bedroom, where Janet and Margaret lie wide-eyed on a shaking bed. In the room, Janet immediately says, "Mom, the bed is shaking." Peggy dismissively responds, "Don't worry, it's probably nothing. Just go to sleep." Peggy lies in bed, trying to ignore the strange noises. Suddenly, a shuffling sound, followed by four loud knocks, breaks the silence. A chest of drawers slides across the floor. She pushes the chest back, but it slides forward again, defying her efforts. The family rushes to the Nottinghams' house for help. Vic Nottingham, a skeptical roofer, and his son Gary accompany them back to investigate. They hear mysterious knocks coming from all over the house. Vic, baffled, says, "I thought it was a prank, but these knocks, they're not human." Police officers arrive, searching for the source of the tapping. But, as they investigate, a chair wobbles and slides across the floor on its own, leaving everyone astounded. Peggy, the children, Vic, and the police officers gather in the kitchen, discussing the bizarre events. Suddenly, objects start flying around the room, marbles, Lego bricks, and more. Reporters from the Daily Mirror, Douglas Bence and Graham Morris, arrive to investigate. They witness the chaos and are targeted by the unseen force, with Lego bricks striking Graham's face. Graham says, astonished and grabbing his face, "It's not a prank. I've been hit by something, but no one is doing anything." Later in the investigation, George Fallows, a senior reporter, and David Thorpe, a photographer, also joined to help. They observe the family and other witnesses as objects move, levitate, and even the sofa rises in the air before crashing down. "This goes beyond trickery," Fallows indicate. "It would take an expert to simulate all of this." Maurice Gross, a member of the Society for Psychical Research, SPR, arrives on September 5th. Chaos and fear fill the house as Maurice witnesses the terrifying activity. Maurice enters, immediately gripped by fear, sensing that something is terribly wrong. Gross, aided by Guy Playfair, another SPR investigator, holds a vigil in the children's bedroom. Suddenly, a loud crash echoes through the house, prompting them to rush in. They find Janet and Margaret still in bed, but a chair has flipped over and moved across the room. News spreads about the haunting, and the house becomes a spectacle. Crowds gather outside, hoping to catch a glimpse of the supernatural events. As the investigation intensifies, Gross and Playfair witness Janet being thrown out of bed by an invisible force. They struggle to understand the nature of the entity tormenting the Hodgson family. Gross and Playfair set up recording equipment, hoping to capture evidence of the paranormal. Suddenly, a deep, eerie voice emerges from Janet, speaking with a distinct otherworldly tone. "Leave this house. This is our home." The investigation reaches its climax as the entity grows more violent and hostile. Objects levitate, doors slam shut, and voices fill the house. The Hodgson family fears for their lives. Gross and Playfair consult with experts in various fields to explore possible explanations for the phenomena. They consider psychological, physical, and paranormal factors. The investigators gather for a meeting, sharing their observations and theories. They discuss the possibility of the haunting being a result of poltergeist activity, where the energy of a living individual inadvertently manifests as paranormal phenomena. The investigation reaches a turning point. On the 14th of December, significant events unfold in the Enfield case. It coincides with Janet's first period, and witnesses report unbelievable occurrences. As the baker's roundsman delivers bread next door, he hears a commotion coming from the Hudson house. Looking through the curtains, he sees Janet floating horizontally, accompanied by flying books and toys. Simultaneously, a lollipop lady across the road witnesses Janet levitating up and down in front of the bedroom window, causing her to fear the window might shatter. To further explore the phenomena, Maurice Gross sets up a microphone in the bedroom. As the family gets into bed, a dog barks in the room, even though there is no dog present. Curiosity leads them to challenge the barking voice to speak. It responds with deep, gruff voices, claiming various identities and offering clues about its presence. The voice exhibits unusual characteristics, speaking for hours on end and using voices that don't match Janet's. It even speaks when Janet's mouth is taped shut and filled with water, defying the laws of ventriloquism. The voice identifies itself as Bill Wilkins, and its details match the circumstances of a deceased man who previously lived in the house. This revelation confounds skeptics, leaving them unsure whether it's a genuine spirit or an entity impersonating the deceased. In July 1978, after almost a year of disturbances, Peggy Hodgson made the decision to have Janet admitted to the Maudsley Hospital for psychiatric testing. Peggy hoped that by removing Janet from the environment, the situation would settle down, bringing relief to their lives. Janet underwent numerous tests and examinations, but to everyone's surprise, the results showed that she was perfectly normal and healthy. Despite Janet's return home with a clean bill of health, the experiences within the house continued to linger. Poltergeist cases often followed a pattern of diminishing over time, possibly due to the reduction in stress levels. Yet even as the activity waned, Peggy always felt a lingering presence, an unsettling feeling that there was still something unknown lurking in the shadows. While some believed that a psychic joker was toying with them, Maurice Gross remained open to the possibility that genuine paranormal phenomena were at play. The credibility of the voice and the unexplained occurrences fueled ongoing debates and investigations. Over the years, Peggy Hodgson remained in the house on Green Street until her passing in 2003. Janet and Margaret, her daughters, went on to lead normal lives. Despite numerous offers of money from the press, none of the family members changed their accounts of what transpired during those tumultuous times. Their steadfastness only added to the enduring intrigue and uncertainty surrounding the case. Many believed the Enfield poltergeist was a hoax, despite numerous witnesses. To this day, the mystery remains unresolved. Was it all an elaborate fabrication, or did something truly unexplainable happen? What are your thoughts on this intriguing story? If you like this video, comment, like, and subscribe for more.